Ryan the Monk Mulcahy. He's back. 7.5 months out, mate, by the time you step back through those ropes.
Yeah, 7.5 months. Had an operation on my hand, so I've got to thank Mike Eaton and Steve Wood for getting that sorted for me. Just started punching about probably full punching 5 weeks ago. Been back 7 weeks now. The first 2 weeks we were just tapping it, and it's back now. It's good, it feels strong, you know, it feels good.
Well, I mean, everything was going like a dream for you. I think you'd only been a pro, what, 6 months, and you'd had the 4 fights?
Busy. Been a pro for a year now. It was 12, I made my debut yesterday, a year ago.
Right.
12 months yesterday, so. The injury, I missed a big Goodison, the bill in Goodison, which would have put me out there a bit more, you know. I missed another bill in the Apple Arena the other week where Bellew defended his world title. So I missed two big bills that would have got me a bit more
exposure.
Yeah, that's the word before, but one of them things.
Well, you're trying to make up for it now, because you're going to be out hopefully twice in 3 weeks. Is it going to be?
Yeah, they're looking at the third fight as well, which I can't say too much about at the minute because it's not confirmed. But yeah, if all goes to plan, by December 20th, I'll have another 3 fights from now, which will put me on 7-0, which is making up for what I missed. At the same time, though, I needed to get this operation because all them fights I had, just struggled, just pain.
Yeah.
It was like 70% and all. I was still knocking people out and winning, but, you know, even the camps, the sparring, everything was just geared around me hand being sore.
Well, let's talk about the first fight that you're making, you come back. It's going to be on the 19th of November at the Victoria Warehouse in Manchester.
Yeah, 19th of November.
You're just going to be fighting 4 threes, is it?
Yeah, just a 4 round, because obviously, as I said, it's only my 7th week back from fucking, you know, I think I boxed in March. That was my last fight.
Yeah. Yeah, I was at the Echo Arena as well, wasn't it? Like John Gordon, Gorman,
the
Irish.
Yeah. And once I knew my hands were gone, that was it. I never come back to boxing gym until September. I just couldn't be arsed with it, to be honest. Yeah. And that was the mistake I made, but I've learned that you can't just, don't get me wrong, I was still training, but I never punched since March till 5 weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
There is a big difference, you know what I mean?
Well, yeah. You're making up for it now, because you've been moving around with Tommy Coyle, you've been down at his gym, and obviously, as I was saying before, this gym that you're at, it's phenomenal. You've got, I think there's 5 or 6 of you that are all really, really talented, all different styles,
yeah.
And all looking to go to 2017 being a big year for you,
yeah.
And you being one of them.
Yeah, that's what I mean. I've got good in-house sparring, so I don't really don't get me wrong, I'm not saying I don't need to go out sparring, but it's good to get out, because we all know each other inside out here.
Mm.
You know, our gym is in the dark a little bit in the pool, you know, I don't like to say too much, but we just call ourselves like the rejects. If no one wants us, no one talks about us, and I don't know why. The results are showing.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, there's no.
Well, I think a lot of people are going to be talking about Lou Willis after that performance against Iberia. You've got Robbie Davies Jr. that's on the world scene now, you know. What is he, WBC International Champion?
Yeah, I think he's ranked number 6 with them.
Yeah.
That organisation. I think he's the continental or international belt. He's got a belt.
But he's had something like 15 fights, and I think he's got 10 stoppages, hasn't he? On
yeah, he's a big puncher, and he stops everyone. He's perfect for television, but obviously, that's up to his team.
You're a guy with bad hands at the time, and you've got 2 stoppages to your name.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's a gym that is producing some punches in.
Yeah, there's not a fancy. Don't do nothing.
You are a throwback, mate, aren't you?
That's
back to the 50s, you are.
Hopefully, that's the style I like. That's what I like, do you know what I mean? They're the fighters I watch. The old school I don't like.
No nonsense.
I don't even really know what's going on in the professional scene now. I couldn't tell you. Light welterweight, well, number ones. I couldn't, honest to God, I don't have a clue. I know the big names, but I don't know who's who. You know, I'm more of an historian. I like the old school fighters rather than what's going on.
It shows in your style.
Yeah,
but
we watch a lot of it, you see.
It's nice to watch, mate. It's good old fashioned, no nonsense, and quite brutal at times.
Brutal, yeah. That's what I mean, yeah, it's good. You know, it's good to get down and spar with Coyle. He's an elite fighter.
Definitely.
In Britain. And all it took from him was he lives the life all year round, do you know what
he
I mean?
Does.
Obviously, as I spoke to Jamie Moore, it's a bit different for someone like him and someone like me. I'm still trying to, I've got to pay rent, pay bills, you know, I've still got to try and live with it. It's like, boxing is his life. It's not really mine at the minute.
Well, you know, he's been a very busy guy. Since I've been doing this, working with VIP, I think he's continuously been ready, except for one fight. They've all been 10, 12 rounder title type fights. And it's been one after another, after another, after another. And he's never been out of the ring for more than, you know, more than probably 4 months at a time. Yeah. You know, the guy is, he just loves it. Yeah. He absolutely loves it. And you can see that he's working, isn't he? He's been working on a few different things and hoping to take him back to, you know, he wants that British title. That's what he's...
I think his heart's set on it, isn't it? But I think, we went down, we'd done some work, and he asked me to come back down, which, so obviously, he must have got something from the spa, which is, I'm happy with, because if I can help him out and he goes and beats John Wayne, but then I can, it's nice to tell people, I was sparring, do you know what I mean?
You help towards that.
He wanted to book me in for a few more, but obviously, with the 19th coming up, I think tomorrow's our last move, and so, it's the last...
Yeah, because this is your last hard week, really, of training now, is it?
I think he's got another two. Because there's fights after mine, so this is the last start week.
And realistically, you're going to be tapering off, you're going to probably just come back in. You're not going to go out of the gym because you've got fight after fight after fight, but it's not going to be hard. No. I think you're going to use this fight as part of your training camp for the next fight.
That's what I mean. This only a four-rounder. I wouldn't even say I'm fully fit, I'm not saying I'm off it, but like where I want to be, I'm not. So, no. This fight, it's just training for them. 2 weeks later, the 3rd of December, that's my first six rounder. Mm-hmm. So, you know, they don't come easy over the six rounds. So, I'm just basically going to do my best next week, get that win.
Well, on the night you're fighting, let's big these up, because it's a cracking night on the 19th of November, because there's going to be Matty Askins against the Irish kid, Tommy McCarthy. Now, that's going to be a British final eliminator. And then on the 3rd of December, when you fight there, there's again another cracking top of the bill, because there's a rematch between Ismael and Sean Lewis.
Yeah, well, to be honest, the one in Lee, the December bill, which I've still got tickets for, by the way, that is a Liverpool show.
I
don't think you could get a venue in Liverpool.
Well, where we normally hold it, I don't think they'd pass the Olympia. They hadn't passed.
Gutted as well over that, because it's right by where I'm from, the Olympia, and I was looking forward to getting in there. But at the same time, everyone come down and support in December would be great. There's everyone from our gym.
Well, I think there is. There's Lloyd Campbell, there's you, there's Brogan, and there's four of you. Luke Willis.
Luke, Brogan. So we'll all have a coaches and that on, so it won't be any bother for people to get up there. But that's a big show for Liverpool. I haven't fought on a show with Luke for years, probably since I was an amateur.
Because you two are really good mates, aren't you? Outside of the ring as well.
Yeah.
And you boxed amateur together and everything, didn't you?
Fucking hell, me with him every day. I'm all over with him there enough every day. I can't get away from
him. He's like a Duracell bunny, you know. He never stops, does he? Just bounces around everywhere in there.
I'm used to it, though. It's only because, I knew Luke a long time, and I pulled him back into boxing.
He mentioned that when I did the interview with him for his pro debut.
I think he seen what I was up to, and it was killing him, not getting in, so I just fucking made him get in.
He's a talented lad though, isn't he?
He is, you know.
Totally different style to you though. He's dancing in there.
Very, very good. He'll make a big, big noise at lightweight.
I think he will.
You know, he's still learning, it's still early. He's getting used to life.
Well, this is proof of the pudding. You know, he's going down, as you've been moving around with Tommy Cole, he's been moving around with Terry Flanagan, hasn't he?
Yeah,
and I think it's the fourth time he's going to be going down there.
Yeah, Terry's asked him to come back a lot, so, you know, he must be struggling with Luke's style, because let's be honest, they don't ask him to come back, he'll beat him. You know, so hopefully he's learning from that. I think he'll see the best of him in his next fight, his debut. At the same time, he hadn't been in a boxing ring for years, and he still looked like he'd never been out of it. So I think his next fight, if you get down and watch him, I think you'll see a really more improved Luke Willis, more professional style, starting to plant his feet. He can punch as well, people don't realise it, because he moves a lot, but once he gets used to the problems...
You don't see his punches coming, because they come from all over the place, don't they? From all player over there.
Once he settles down to the pro box, and he's starting to get a feel for it now, about how to win rounds, how to rest, you know, when to aim people, how to be dirty, and it's starting to show. And to after I had a little phone call with him last night before he sparred Flanagan and told him a few things, and he's come in today and told me they work, so I and I'm happy he's trying them as well, so I mean, we all just learn off each other, it's good.
Yeah, yeah.
It's good stuff.
Well, like I said, I think it could be a big year for Thompson's gym, or Elite Performance Centre, as it's as he's known, that's a posh name.
That's
for
the
it.
Public, that's Tom Gym, it's always going to be Tom Gym.
Right, well listen, 19th of November, down at Victoria Warehouse. We're not sure you're fine, but it's just getting you back out there again, ready for
the
December
one.
The 3rd, where basically the whole of your gym's down there, and most of the fighters on that bill are Liverpool lads as well.
Yeah, that's it. So I'd like to thank a few people who've been helping me out since I've come back, because obviously with this 8-month layoff I had a bit of a bad time. I lost all my sponsors due to inactivity and stuff like that. So you know, the good people have stuck by me, like Carl and Paul O'Donnell down at Phoenix Fitness. I do all my strength work with them, do a lot of kettlebells down there, you know, and they don't just help me out as like strength and that, coaches, they're good mentors as well, they're on the phone whenever I need them, good people to be around. And also Ben at HMW Nutrition. This is the first time I've ever dieted, don't get me wrong, I used to think I dieted, but like he's been doing all my meals for me. And you'll see the shape of me on the night. It's paid off a lot. It's strange. I don't feel like I'm dieting, I'm eating all the time. So
you feel strong in that ring?
Yeah, them two helping me out, and obviously John Edge as well has been pushing my name out there as well, trying to get me a few sponsors to help me out, and I appreciate that as well. He's a good fella.
Brian, good luck for the 19th and good luck for the 3rd as well, mate. Hopefully I'll be chatting to you then.
Thanks,
see you on, mate.
Nice one.